morning, everyone. How's everyone doing? I had a dream last night. I wanted to put this dream out as soon as possible. Last night I had a dream that the flood had came. It was an awful flood, you guys. I dreamed that I was, we were being warned. Everyone was leaving town. Everyone was leaving the city. Everyone was running, like packing their bags. Just, and you could see people from far away just coming up. Everyone was going north. Everyone had to go north. It was itself. All I know is everyone was heading up, and they knew that the flood was coming. The flood was coming. And all of a sudden, while everybody was leaving and everything, you guys, I'm sorry, but I'm just telling you exactly what I saw. I noticed these zombies. Yes, I know, zombies. I noticed these zombies, and to tell you the truth, this is the second time I dream of zombies being real in the ends of time. So I noticed these zombies coming at us, these people that were sick, and if they bit you, you would turn like them. They looked just like zombies. They were fast though. They weren't slow. They were really, really fast. And they were just attacking everyone in their path. One of them started coming after me, and I had my daughter. It was just me, my daughter, and my mother. And one of them was coming after me, so I ran. And I ran towards all these people. I noticed it was this place where all these men, it's like a bunch of men were there. A bunch of them, like, I couldn't even count how many guys were there. It were all men. And they were in this castle. And I'm looking at them, I'm like, I need y'all help, I need y'all help. And they were like, you can stay here. I was like, you want me to stay here, all these men? I was like, I'm the only woman here, and my daughter, I don't feel safe with all of you men. So the guy was like, don't worry, I'll look out for you, but you can stay here, everything will be fine. And then I looked, and I was like, I noticed they all left all of a sudden, and they all left me in this castle. I was in this big, big old castle all by myself, but just me, my daughter, and my mother. And I think my sister had joined me. And I'm looking, and I'm like, I noticed the place was very secure. It was a very secure place, and it was huge. It was like many rooms, many hideouts. It was big. And I noticed these zombies, like I would look out the windows and I noticed these zombies was from far away was just attacking people. And I'm like, why can't people come in here? We have plenty of rooms. And I don't know, like my mother, and it's funny, my mother wouldn't allow anyone in this building. Like she was like, nobody can come in here, we're not gonna let nobody in here because they're gonna try to take over and stuff like that. No. And I'm like, so we're just gonna sit out here and wait for all these people to just get devoured by all these beasts, all these creatures? And then the flood came. It started raining, like it was raining a lot. It was not like little rain, like big giant balls of rain was just dropping, and it started flooding the whole town, and it was washing out. And I noticed, I remember the flood passed the castle where we were staying in. It went over it, and I screamed out loud. I was like, oh my gosh, the water's rising. And I noticed it rose, like, I would say 50 foot high. It was so high. And I'm looking at this castle all around, like we're all flooded. And then I noticed the air started coming out of the room. Even though the inside of the castle did not have any water inside of it. And I have no idea where I was. I have no idea. All I know, all these guys left us there alone. And they went out there fighting or whatever. I don't know what they were doing. But I noticed that after the water went back down from the castle. Like, I don't know, it looked like the water, first we was flooded with water. It was a bunch of water there. And then I noticed the water just like flooded under the, I don't know, it was just, all the water drained it. Like, it got drained it out and stuff like that. And then after that, I went outside, I looked, and I saw all the water was gone. And I told my mom that I wanted to leave this place. I had to leave this place. And she was like, "You're not going nowhere." And I was like, "Yes, I am. I'm taking my daughter and I'm leaving." And she was like, you can't leave. You can't go nowhere. I'm like, "I'm leaving. No, I'm not staying here. I don't even know when where is safe." She was like, we're safe in here. I was like, I want to get out of here. I just had to leave. So I packed my stuff and I just left. I took my daughter. And as I was leaving, I saw these guys, all these guys. I saw them. I was like, "You guys, where you guys been?" And it was like, "We've been guarding this castle." So the whole time they was guarding the castle, and I never even saw them, not one time. And then I told them we had to leave because something big was coming. It was like, "It's okay, we're gonna be fine." I was like, "But the flood is coming. It was just, the castle was just flooded, and it's about to be flooded again. I know it's coming. It's coming. The flood is coming." I kept screaming out, "The flood is coming. The flood is coming." And then I noticed they were telling me, you know, "Hang in there. You don't worry. Everything's gonna be fine." I was like, "But it's gonna be 50 foot of water coming back." And they were like, "Really?" I was like, "Yes. We gotta go." And I don't know what happened. I don't remember me leaving or anything like that. But I do remember waking up and it was time for me to take the kids to school. But other than that, I, you know, I woke up and I was like, "Whoa, that was a crazy dream." And I was like, "This is the second time around I dreamed of zombies. Zombies are there." And I'm glad I was taken to a place where I was safe. At least I was safe in this castle place or whatever. And it was crazy because everyone out there was getting tortured by these zombies that bit them, that hurt them, that was coming after them. People was running for their lives. I guess this was another end time stream. I think you guys need to be ready because if people don't get taken during the great rapture, when God come and take his, you know, faithful ones, if you get left here, just know you're going to go through some hell. The things you're going to see that you didn't even think would exist in this world will torment you. People were broken. People was hysterical. They lost their minds. People couldn't even run. They couldn't even fight for themselves. They couldn't even move. Like, they were frozen, like stuck, like so scared. They couldn't even leave. And they were getting eaten by these zombies. These zombies were just tearing them up. I was like, "Oh my gosh." Oh my gosh. And I'm watching all of this, but as I'm watching all of this, I'm somewhere safe and protected. And I couldn't help these people. I couldn't do anything to help them. My hands were tied. So I believe these days, you guys better be ready if you're willing to stick it through and live during this great tribulation. It's not going to be pretty. It's going to be hell on earth. So I tell you, brothers and sisters, don't wait to give your life to God. Don't wait to serve God. Don't wait to build a relationship with God. Do it now. Do it quickly. Because any day, any time now, he can show up and just leave you behind. You don't want to be left behind. God bless you guys. I just wanted to share this dream with you guys. Take it to the Lord. God bless you. Shalom. I gotta thank you. Just wanna thank you for what you've done. Thank
thank you for everything.
Just wanna tell you that you're the one.